Hi, I'm Victoria, and I'm here at the Greenville County Library System. This is another episode of Wacky Science. Today's experiment comes from the book Recycled Science by Tammy Enns and Jody Wheeler-Toppin. We're going to do a series of Wacky Science videos that focus on recycling and composting and ways to make the environment better. Not just not put trash in the environment, but also how to improve it, how to make it better. Because every little bit counts. Our house is on fire, guys. Do everything you can. And so this is a way that you can contribute in your own way. So, the materials that you're gonna need today are a 2-liter bottle, cut in half. Please ask an adult to do this for you because it can be sharp. So, 2-liter bottle, cut in half. A smaller Coke bottle, water bottle, that's also been cut in half. You're gonna need some worms. I just went to my local gas station to get some fishing worms. You don't have to do that, it was just easier for me. Another trick that you can do, go out in your backyard, take a piece of cardboard, lay it on the ground, soak it with your hose, and leave it overnight. Then when you come back in the morning and you lift up the cardboard, there should be worms underneath. So that's a way that you can get worms, or of course just go and dig in your garden because it's fun. So you'll need your bottles, your worms, some water, some dirt. Again, you don't have to buy it. You have dirt in your backyard. Just go dig it up. And some fruit and vegetable scraps from your kitchen. So let's get started. So I've got the bottom end of my 2-liter bottle and the bottom end of my smaller bottle. You're gonna fit it in the middle. And really the only purpose of the smaller bottle in the middle is just to keep the worms pushed closer to the edge of the compost bin so you can see them more easily. So if you don't have that smaller bottle, you can still do this experiment here. I'm gonna take my dirt, take a handful of it, and holding the bottle that's in the middle in place, just gonna layer some dirt on the bottom. Not much, just enough to kind of hold the bottle steady. And then I'll take my vegetable pieces, kind of tear them into smaller pieces. Oh my goodness, lettuce is strong. Okay, there we go. And it doesn't matter, fruit, vegetable, whatever you have. But the reason that we're doing fruits and vegetables, did you know that food waste is one of the biggest contributors to global warming? Both in that when we throw it away, it contributes to methane production as it breaks down, but also because it's just wasted food. And all that work and energy that went into producing the food is then put to waste. So we use the vegetable scraps to just make use of every little bit of waste that we can. So I'm just gonna keep layering it. Keep patting it down, tamping it down in between the layers, because otherwise it'll get really fluffy and take up more space than you need it to. Now I'm doing another layer. Another layer, making a mess, tamp that down, and if you can see, it's about an inch each time. It doesn't need to be perfect. More vegetables. Apple cores, banana peels. You just don't want anything that's been salted or anything that's got dairy on it, just because it'll start to stink. Make my little worm home. There's one layer. This will be my last layer before I put in the worms. If you do go out and buy worms, look for night crawlers or red something. Night crawlers or red worms. I think they're just called red earthworms. Okay. So I've got my little home.
I'm gonna get out my buddies.
Oh, and also be sure if you do gather the worms ahead of time, you want to keep them in nice damp soil and possibly even in your fridge if that won't gross out your family. But keeping them nice and cool and in a dark place will help the worms last, because we want this to be a home for them. We don't want to hurt them. I'm going to layer my worms.
Look at him, he's so cute and fat, he's a junker. Put my little worm in there.
I think I should name them. That one's Fred. This is Bob. Henry. Let's do one more.
Phil the worm.
Okay. I'm also gonna take a little bit of the dirt that they came with. So I ended up putting four worms in there, five worms. Oh no, we need a fifth name. How about Sam? Layer them in there. Ooh, they're wiggly.
Look at them, they're wiggling. Oh, they're so cute.
There you go, little dudes. I saved them from a terrible fate because they were fishing worms. They were bait worms. Not anymore though. They're gonna be the fattest worms ever. Okay, so it's a little bit of the dirt. And then one more layer of the vegetable material. Boop. He's just wiggling in there. I think that one's Sam. Hi, Phil. Cover you up there, buddy. Tuck him in. Tuck him in nice and tight. Maybe read him a bedtime story. Okay. And then just a little bit more dirt. Their home. The final step is to take your water, and you don't want it. You're not trying to soak the compost bin. You just want it to be. Think of how healthy soil feels. It's kind of damp. It's not soaking like mud, but if you touched it, you would definitely feel that moisture on your fingers. So just a little. And now you're going to want to keep this in a cool, darker space, because again, think about the environment that earthworms like to live in. It's deep underground, it's dark, it's cold. So keep them somewhere out of direct sunlight, somewhere nice and cool, and you should start to see them break down the material. You'll notice what their poop looks like is just kind of little grains of dirt. Just tiny, like little sprinkle sized. But it's good, healthy stuff. It's not gross. It's perfect material for gardening, for vegetable gardening. And also if it starts to stink, you may have done something wrong. Maybe you dump it in your backyard and start over. This shouldn't be something that stinks. It should just kind of smell like fresh dirt. Thank you again so much for joining us. I hope you had fun, and we'll see you again. Bye.